Detroit Board of Education Committee, a whole meeting to be held Monday, September 29th at 5 o'clock at the wonderful Renaissance High School will now come to order. Madam Secretary, would you please call the roll?
Good evening, Mr. President, esteemed members of this democratically elected Board of Education. My name is Karen Toomey. I am the Secretary of the Ferndale Board of Education. Joining me today are trustees Jennifer Latosh and our Vice President, Nancy Kerr-Mueller. In just a moment, our Vice President is going to share with you a letter that our President wrote to this body to show our support. But first, I just wanted to thank you for the opportunity for us to address you and show our support, because having talked to members of this audience, I've realized that we are certainly not the one and only, but we are one of many in the region that support this Board of Education. And I also wanted to quickly just apologize for having taken so long to get here, and I wanted to just quickly share my pathway to come tonight. You see, it was about 1 month ago that I went to my mailbox and I opened it to find a letter from the EAA. Some of you may have seen me before. This was a letter that was inviting my child to attend an EAA school. Or shall I say, this was a letter inviting my child to be a laboratory rat in the for-profit experiment of Buzz Software. You see, that letter, though, was my wake-up call. And it inspired me to do a little of my own research. And what I found was this. I found that over the last 15 years of the Detroit Public Schools, 12 have been under emergency management. I also found that the 3 years under your local governance had the best academic, financial, and enrollment markers of any of the 15 years. Since before 1999, thank you, Mr. Trump. And so, we stand here tonight to give you our pledge that we are going to share the truth, because I hadn't heard that narrative. And the reason I hadn't heard that narrative is because the truth was inconvenient for those profiteers who wanted to come in and cannibalize Detroit and our public schools. And so we tonight pledge that we are going to write letters, and we are going to share the truth. We're going to tell the truth about Oakman, we're going to tell the truth about Ferguson, and we are going to tell the truth about this Board of Education. And so now, I offer you our Vice President, Nancy Kerr-Mueller.
Residential racial racial segregation on students and their teachers, and the heroic work of schools and teachers to overcome those effects. We realize that an undemocratic state takeover of a local school district can undermine public support for public school districts. We are your neighbors, and while we compete for some of the same students, we have so much more in common. School districts and communities in Oakland County and throughout Michigan need Detroit public schools to thrive and to reflect the will of Detroit residents. If the state government wants to help students in Detroit and the inner ring suburbs, it should help finance modern, efficient infrastructure, more teachers and resources for at-risk students, new technology, and take real action to reduce poverty and the effects of racism. Please let Ferndale's board know how we can best work together with Detroit's board in the goal of helping all of our students thrive and succeed. Sincerely, Jim O'Donnell.
Really appreciate it, and we look forward to working collaboratively for improved education in the region.
I am the Democratic candidate for state rep. I won the primary in August and looking forward to winning November.
Very nice. And why is education important to you?
I am a first generation high school and college graduate myself. Also a former science teacher with Detroit Public Schools. So I understand the importance of education, and public education is really the foundation, the core of democracy. And so it's important that we provide great quality education to all of our children. I'm also the mom of a son, Jordan, who's 21 years old, who graduated from DPS K through 12. He had a learning difference, and so I was his advocate, and so I gained the sensitivity towards advocating for the rest of our children. And so this has become personal for me to fight for all of our children to have a fair shake at getting a great quality education and then be successful in life.
Now, how has the state coming in and taking over education, essentially, in Detroit schools, how has that affected the district?
Oh, my God. We've closed more schools under Governor Snyder than any other governor in the history of Michigan. It has caused and forced children to not be able to go to their neighborhood schools. It's the privatization model for other people to profit at the expense of our children is wrong. Tonight we're here reviewing a film, Oakland Schools, one of the only schools for the handicapped and the disabled children who were forced to go into the classrooms. Third grade, sixth grade, seventh grade, I mean, it just totally disenfranchised them. The development of the EAA, which throughout all of our students, IEPs, their federally mandated programs that would ensure that they have the support necessary to be successful. And so our children are like cattle in the classroom being shifted around. Teacher turnover is very high. There's no stability in these experimental schools. And so it's wrong. And we know that if children don't get a great education, it is helping to fuel the pipeline to prison. And so it is all of us should be fighting. This is a bipartisan issue. This issue knows no color, no socioeconomic status, but we have to fight for our children to make sure that all of them are able to get quality education. Their lives depend on it, and so does ours.